Conan, what is best in life? To crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and to hear the lamentation of the women. That is good. That is good.
Hello, and welcome to Forces of Destruction. This will be round two of the March Hare event in Omaha, Nebraska, 2400-point tournament. After my frustrating game with the Wood Elves, I was looking forward to a matchup, and in the drawings, ended up pairing off against my buddy Alan, who I play against all the time with his 2400-point Skaven list. So I thought we fight enough. I should be able to get myself a victory out of this one. Really looking forward to it. My wizard, I rolled up the spells of the Vortex, and I rolled doubles, so I ended up with the Vortex, and then I ended up with the Magic Missile spell with my Ruby Ring as well. And here's my Skaven opponent. He deploys here. Pretty simple deployment, playing Battle for the Pass. You know, we've done this scenario many times, and I've been pretty victorious. So in this battle, I'm pretty confident that I'm going to be able to get myself a victory, and which is always good in a tournament. I'm hoping for, after my draw, I'm hoping to score high. You know, I really want to get a 20 or 18-2 win, but we'll see how it goes. Here's my deployment. I've got my trolls over on the far left and my general's unit with his wolf riders. Now, when I saw my opponent deploy, I figured my savage orcs could hold out against his plague monks. The middle, I could type a storm vermin with my bust up, semi-bust up unit of biggins. His Gracier and BSB in this far left unit. His generals in the storm vermin. So if I just hit this general, turn this corner, and move down the flank, that's my plan. And then everything else, just stall until help can arrive. Real quick, a few pictures of my deployment again. Again, you know, Savage Orcs, good matchup. Biggins, good matchup. Got my little Mangler Squig there in the middle just to help out. And then my left side against his right, I have him outmatched with my general guiding them trolls along. And my general's unit should be able to just turn the corner and wipe him out. Skaven gets first turn, and right off the bat, his help hit rolls triples, rolls out of control. He does not hit the storm room, though. He falls just short. So, good start to the game. Everything else in his list starts to advance up the board. His general's unit, I think, kind of sees that he's outmatched, and he just kind of turns and starts trying to move towards the middle of the board there. That help hit staying back is great. That's the only thing I'm really concerned about. Everything else, I've fought so many times, I know I can hold my own against him. So that's his turn one. Lightning cannons, I don't believe, do much of anything. So orcs go to their turn one, and I move up as fast as I'm able to there. Mangler Squig rolls really high, like a 17, moves to the top of that hill there. It's a great good spot for it. Trolls are kind of angling to work their way into these slaves and turn the corner. My general's unit, unfortunately, didn't have quite enough room to squeeze by, but they're in a good spot right there. They're pretty quick movers. I can take my time. I figure by turn three, I'll have this game in the bag. But my opponent has other ideas. Skaven turn two. He moves his slaves right up there. Kind of blocks off my biggins from being able to do anything. His general's unit continues to worm its way back behind there. The storm vermin looks like they just stuck back. Plague monks move up. The hell pit rolls pretty decently and catches back up with his units. One of his lightning cannons destroys itself with a misfire, so that was good. I always like to see that. And at this right here, I'm still liking it. I got trolls and trolls into the slaves there, and when I charge my trolls out, you know, I'll have room for my general. So on my turn, that's what I do. I declare charges with both units of trolls, and then I charge his general's unit with my general's unit, because my trolls would be out of the way. So I'll make my one wheel, and I can hit that unit. If I hit that unit in the side, I know I know that that little wind mortar thing is kind of in the way, but I should be able to dominate that unit, even with just a few models. I have my big boss goblin and my general. If he would take a challenge, I'll wipe him out. Should be able to beat that unit. If I can maybe overrun or whatever, I'll just be in a good spot. Both chariots charge those skirmishers, and I'm hoping to obliterate them and overrun into the side of the hell pit and get some more impact hits on him. I know my chariots will die to it, but you know, I've got 2d6 plus 2 strength 5 impact hits. I don't know, it's worth the shot. Here's where my charges are. I do not make the long charge with my cavalry into there, so the game is not going to be so easily won. I make a mistake right here. I decide not to charge with my orcs, and I reform them just to the side so I can go towards those storm vermin on later turns or be ready for them. If I would have made contact with that unit, I would have had my ranks, and then he would have popped that turn. But as you'll see, he does not. I pwn him, but I do not pop him, and that sucks. That's my mistake. My chariots do wipe that unit out and overrun into the side of the hell pit abomination. And my Mangler Squig had gone through, was able to go through the Storm Vermin and the Plague Monks. And I wiped out 10 Plague Monks. I rolled great. And so now I'm really confident my Savage Orcs can take out the depleted Plague Monks. Because his Storm Vermin are actually on top of that hill where the banner is. They're not so far back. So, yeah, it's looking good. I'm still happy. However, I did not pop those slaves because I stupidly did not put my unit in there, and so that's bad. His Storm Vermin charge my biggins. I'm pretty happy with that. It's a pretty even fight. I think I'll be able to hold on there and weather that. Those slaves should be gone, though. My mistake. His Plague Monks charge my Savage Orcs. Again, you know, I've got him outnumbered. He's got his banner, and I know if I can weather that banner, then I will be able to wear them down, usually. But there, you know, it's dicey. It's a 50-50 with that battle. So in the middle here, I stop his Death Frenzy spell, which is great, and now I'm really happy about this fight. And he gets off plague, and I let it go. I think I had a couple dice. I was kind of happy with that. I've toughness 4, he's toughness 3. He ends up killing a ton of his own guys, and he gets quite a few of mine too. I roll not so good. So there's the post plague, and then on the attacking, Queek's not that great against troops, and he ends up killing, I think, 3. And then out of his 10 attacks, he's weapon skill 5, strength 5, so he's got me outmatched. And he rolls like a champ, and I roll horribly. And I am one man short from being steadfast. One body short from being steadfast, and I'm not steadfast. I break on a 5 rerollable, and or actually, I was outside of my generals. I might have been outside of my generals, and so he kills them, runs them down. Ugh. And then I get really bad with the pictures at this point because we're really starting to speed up. His general's unit had fled away from my general's unit. There, just can't get him. His hell pit kills a wolf. a chariot and runs after the other one who is fleeing. Now, the Plague Monk battle, I mean, if you look at the numbers, I've got him. He rolls really well. I roll, he wins the combat. So, breaks my frenzy. I don't flee, though, because I was steadfast. But, sorry for the pictures. I skip a bunch because we were pressed for time and just were kind of racing. And now, at this point, I'm losing. So, I'm trying to hurry up and play. And, in two rounds of combat, he beats my Savage Orcs and runs them down with just a handful of Plague Monks left. So I am really hurting at this point. And it's not good. So I end up popping those slaves and forming my trolls up. And then I get to reform. And I end up getting one unit charged into the Hell Pit. And my general's unit is going after his BSB and Grey Seer unit. And in the next couple pictures, I just kind of skip ahead. I've got my unit. I had got my wolves obliterated on a miscast, I believe. But he actually, it was the last turn of the game at this point, and he fled with his last turn. On my turn before, he fled and he rolled crappy. And I was able to catch his unit and reform. Then on my turn, you see my wizard there behind his hell pit. I move him as far as he can, 18 inches up. It's desperation time for me. His plague monks wipe me out. His storm vermin have wiped me out. My trolls are engaged with his hell pit, trying to score those points. My last turn, I charge my other unit of trolls in. He's only got a few wounds left on the hell pit, trying to finish him off. And with his Gracier being dead and his BSB, he probably should have held on that one, but he thought he could get away. And he, in most mathematical situations, he would have. And then my champion of the match is my wizard. He throws a large vortex. I roll enough. I also roll far enough so it goes right over the top of the storm vermin unit, and I kill all but like one remaining storm vermin and the general. And then with my ruby ring, because I rolled 11 power dice too, go figure, I never do that. And with my ruby ring and my large magic missile spell, I'm able to finish off the storm vermin unit. A miracle last turn type of thing. And it was just a fluke. My opponent had me beat, and there's no ifs, ands, or buts. Big mistake was when I didn't touch that unit of Biggins into those slaves and pop them immediately. And so we do the math, total it up. I end up with a 12-8 victory. He had finished off those war machines in the back there, and so very fortunate to escape with even a last-ditch, last-turn victory. Unfortunately, we were running so late on time, like everybody else was done except us, so we had to grab our stuff and move to the next table. I did win a door prize at this point. I won the Watchtower, a nice piece of terrain. Very excited about that, because at home my terrain, if you've seen any of my videos, is not very good. So I got a new watchtower that I can put together and paint, and so I'm very happy. I've won back way more than my $15 entry fee, and we've had pizza at this point, so it's a win-win. Two good games. I'm gonna give the victory to Alan in reality, but he played a great game, and look forward to playing him again in the near future. And so it's off to round 3 against my next opponent, and thank you for watching, and I will get that battle report up very shortly.